dears, this is Raji. In this video, we are going to discuss about the chemical properties of sulfuric acid. What's so special about sulfuric acid? Sulfuric acid will be exhibiting different properties in the dilute state as well as in the concentrated state. Just like a coin has got two sides, correct? Yes. Concentrated sulfuric acid can act as dehydrating agent, non-volatile acid and an oxidizing agent also. In this video, we will be discussing about the dehydrating property as well as the non-volatile acid property of concentrated sulfuric acid. And at the end of the video, we will be discussing the board questions also related to that. Concentrated sulfuric acid can act as a dehydrating agent, we said. What do you mean by this dehydrating agent? First write some examples. Okay, then we will get an idea. So can you tell me what is the formula of formic acid? That is HCOOH. It is also known as methanoic acid, right? So this formic acid, we are treating it with concentrated sulfuric acid. Write and see what will happen. Concentrated sulfuric acid can remove this OH also and this H also from formic acid. As a result, together it will become one molecule of water, correct? Then what is remaining? One more gas you will be getting, that is carbon monoxide gas, correct? Now write another example. Oxalic acid you write. What's the formula? Two carboxylic acid units joined together. Okay, you will be getting oxalic acid. This oxalic acid, when treated with concentrated sulfuric acid, write and see what will happen. See, it will be removing this H also and this OH also from oxalic acid, right? And so one product obtained will be water. What will be the other gas formed? See, that is carbon dioxide. Along with that, one more gas will be formed. What is that? That is carbon monoxide. So easy, right? Write one more example, ethanol. Okay, so ethanol is CH3CH2OH. To understand, I am writing it as CH2H. Then CH2OH you can write. If you are treating it with concentrated sulfuric acid and heating the mixture to 170 degrees Celsius, that this OH will be removed and this H will be removed from ethanol. Together, it will become one molecule of water. Then what is remaining? That is C2H4. What is C2H4? It is nothing but ethene gas. Easy, no? So what's so special about all these reactions? When these compounds are treated with concentrated sulfuric acid, okay, a molecule of water is removed from these compounds. Okay, why? Because concentrated sulfuric acid has a strong affinity towards water. So that is the reason we call it as a dehydrating agent. Got it? Related to the dehydrating property of sulfuric acid, we will have to understand one more point. See this picture. In this container, we have hydrogen chloride gas. But the gas has got some moisture also. That means some amount of water vapor also is present along with it. We want only hydrogen chloride gas, or we want to dry the gas. So what we will do? We will pass it through concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay. Concentrated sulfuric acid can remove water from this mixture. You will be getting dry HCl gas. Here, concentrated sulfuric acid is removing moisture. So, in this case, it is acting as a drying agent, we will say. Agreed? Now, see the next container. In that, oxalic acid is present. If you are treating this oxalic acid with concentrated H2SO4, what will happen? Water will be removed. But there is no moisture present in this oxalic acid, right? Then from where water is removed? That is, chemically combined hydrogen and oxygen is removed in such a way that it will be getting converted into water. Understood? So, in this case, concentrated sulfuric acid will be acting as a dehydrating agent, we will say. Got the idea? So, drying agent will remove only the moisture from the gas. or it will dry the gas only. Whereas dehydrating agent will be removing the water that is chemically combined in the compound. Got it now? So you should remember that concept. Okay. See this picture. Concentrated sulfuric acid has got some interesting properties. We have taken some cane sugar in this beaker. Okay. And to that we are adding concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay. What will happen? Within minutes, the cane sugar will be getting converted into a black spongy mass. What's happening over here? Write and see. What's the formula of cane sugar? C12H22O11. When it is treated with concentrated sulfuric acid, what will happen? Concentrated sulfuric acid can act as a dehydrating agent and it can remove chemically combined water from it. Correct? Yeah. How many molecules of water you will be getting from this H22O11? Yeah, that will be 11 molecules of water. Along with that, 12 atoms of carbon also will be formed. So sugar will be getting converted into sugar charcoal, you can say. So whatever you can see in this picture is nothing but sugar charcoal. Okay. Yeah. Instead of cane sugar, if you are taking some glucose or fructose, what will happen? What's the formula? Write and see. That will be C6H12O6. Okay. Yeah. Glucose also, fructose also will be having the same molecular formula. Treated with concentrated sulfuric acid, it can remove chemically combined water that is present inside glucose. Okay, how many molecules of water will be removed? 6H2O. Along with that, 6 atoms of carbon also will be formed. Correct, no? Yeah. So related to this, what will be the observation of the reaction they will be asking? When concentrated sulfuric acid is added to sugar, a black spongy mass will be formed with steam evolving out, you should write. So this is the black spongy mass. Okay, and can you see this one? Some amount of water is removed now. Okay, you can see it as water vapor from here. Yeah, in this reaction also, sulfuric acid is acting as a dehydrating agent. That also you should remember. Got it? Related to the dehydrating property of concentrated sulfuric acid, we need to learn one more reaction. Can you tell me what will be the formula of hydrated copper sulfate, that is COSO4.5H2O? This 5 molecules of water that is associated with copper sulfate crystal is known as water of crystallization. This is responsible for the color of the salt, and at the same time it will give a crystalline nature to the salt. By this time we are adding few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid into this hydrated copper sulfate. So what will happen? Being a dehydrating agent, concentrated sulfuric acid can remove this 5 molecule of water from it. As a result, hydrated copper sulfate will be turning into anhydrous copper sulfate. Anhydrous copper sulfate will not be having any water of crystallization with it. If there is no water of crystallization, what will be the color of anhydrous copper sulfate? It will be colorless. And at the same time, it will be losing that crystalline nature and it will be turning into a white amorphous powder, you should write. So in this reaction also, concentrated sulfuric acid is acting as a dehydrating agent. You should remember. Okay. Yes. So we were learning about the dehydrating property of concentrated sulfuric acid. Now we need to learn another property of concentrated sulfuric acid, that is non-volatile acid property. If you have learned the chapter sulfuric acid and hydrogen chloride, you will be knowing that. Yeah. Concentrated sulfuric acid is used for the preparation of other mineral acids in the laboratory. Yeah. So how can you prepare hydrogen chloride gas in the laboratory? Write and see. We need to take some sodium chloride. To that we will add concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay. And the mixture will be heated to a temperature below 200 degrees Celsius. Right. Yeah. So what will happen? You will be getting sodium bisulfate. Along with that, hydrogen chloride gas also will be produced. If you are dissolving this hydrogen chloride gas in water using a funnel arrangement, you will be getting hydrochloric acid. Correct? Yeah. Now, question will be coming to mind. Why concentrated sulfuric acid is used for the preparation of other acid? Because it is considered as a non-volatile acid. That means its boiling point is very high. Exactly speaking, its boiling point is 337 degrees Celsius. If you are heating the reaction mixture to 200 degrees Celsius also, concentrated sulfuric acid will not decompose as its boiling point is higher. So, this property of concentrated sulfuric acid is known as non-volatile acid property. You should memorize. Now, see this picture. How can you prepare nitric acid in the laboratory? You will be knowing, right? And see, you can take either potassium nitrate or sodium nitrate. Add concentrated sulfuric acid into that and we will heat the mixture to below 200 degrees Celsius. Then what will happen? You will be getting potassium bisulfate. Along with that, nitric acid also will be produced. Easy. Okay. So in this case also, why we are not using hydrochloric acid for this purpose? Because nitric acid also, hydrochloric acid also will be decomposing easily. Okay. They are volatile, we can say. Whereas the boiling point of concentrated sulfuric acid is higher, it won't decompose easily. So, which property of concentrated sulfuric acid is utilized in this experiment? That is non-volatile acid property. Will you remember? You should remember. Okay. Now see the question. These are the questions related to the property of concentrated sulfuric acid. Read and find out. What's the property of concentrated sulfuric acid which allows it to be used in the preparation of hydrogen chloride and nitric acid? So, concentrated sulfuric acid is used for the preparation of other acids, we said. Do you remember which property of concentrated sulfuric acid will be utilized in that? That is non-volatile acid property. See, it won't decompose easily due to that. Okay, read the next one. What property of concentrated sulfuric acid is in action when sugar turned black in its presence? We have learned that already. Which property is utilized in that? That is the dehydrating property. It has a strong tendency to remove water from certain substances. Dehydrating agent. Okay, got it. Now, see this question. Name the gas evolved in each case and formula not acceptable. The gas produced by the action of concentrated sulfuric acid on sodium chloride. Write and see, sodium chloride and concentrated sulfuric acid. Now only we have written, right? If the mixture is not heated above 200 degrees Celsius, what will be the product obtained? You will be getting sodium bisulfate and hydrogen chloride gas will be formed. They are asking the gas produced. Okay, And they are telling formula not acceptable. So you will have to write it as hydrogen chloride. Okay. See the next one. What property of sulfuric acid is shown by the reaction of concentrated sulfuric acid when it is heated with potassium nitrate? Write and see what will be the product of the reaction if you are not heating the mixture above 200 degrees Celsius. Okay, you will be getting potassium bisulfate. Along with that, nitric acid also will be formed. It is used for the preparation of other acid, right? So, which property? That is non-volatile acid property of concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay, you can remember. Then, next one. Read and find out. Write the observation of the reaction. Sugar crystals are added to a hard glass test tube containing concentrated sulfuric acid. We had discussed that also. Okay, concentrated sulfuric acid being a strong dehydrating agent. It can remove water from the sugar crystals. Okay, as a result, a black spongy mass will be formed with steam evolving out of it. You should write. Okay, got it. Concentrated sulfuric acid is added to copper sulfate crystals. See, whenever they are telling copper sulfate crystal, what will be the color of copper sulfate crystals? It will be blue in color. That means water of crystallization will be associated with it. CuSO4.5H2O. If you are adding concentrated sulfuric acid to that, that water of crystallization will be lost. As a result, it will become anhydrous copper sulfate. What will be the color of anhydrous copper sulfate? It will be colorless powdery substance. So how can you write the observation of the reaction? Yeah, concentrated sulfuric acid is added to copper sulfate crystals. Blue colored copper sulfate crystals will be turning into a white amorphous powder, you should write. Okay, yeah. We have discussed the non-volatile acid property as well as the dehydrating property of concentrated sulfuric acid. The oxidizing as well as the dilute acid property we will be discussing in the next video. Thanks for watching. Keep on working hard.